Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be answering a question that was asked on Reddit by Aunt Marge, where she asks how to get this sort of like cutout shape. She has this part, and how does she get it so that it is cut out of the actual shape? We're going to show that after the intro. We're going to start here by just making a rectangle. So make a rectangle here. And you saw in her file, she had this shape already set out. Let's be a little bit more careful. We make sure the tangent is about there. Pull this down. We're going to flip this guy. So I'm going to have to make that a shape so that I can flip it along the blue axis. You can't flip a just a line. It has to be a geometry. Blue direction. There we go. Let's just delete this little bit. Okay. So we have that guy. Let's just reverse this face. And delete this guy. Boop. So I'm essentially just trying to get what she had. Flip along red axis, and then make this here. And then we'll squish this a little bit. So I'm going to show you a couple different ways that you can do this, and one might serve you better than the other. But if you have basically the shape of something, it's pretty easy to just construct it from scratch. SketchUp works in faces. So because these are symmetrical faces, what you can do actually is come into this and just find the endpoints and connect them across. So we're just going to do that really quickly. Because all of these endpoints are planar. So this is a little tedious to do this, but we'll get you what you're looking for. Okay, and I think the rest of that's flat. So then if I come up all the way to the top here, I'm not going to do the top portion just to save you guys some time. Just want to get that shape. Now, obviously you probably don't want this, so if I hit E for the eraser tool and then hold control, I can drag over this. I'm pressing the left mouse key while holding control, and it will hide those lines. And if I go to view hidden geometry, you can see that those are there, but that essentially smooths out the geometry. So that's one way to do it. The second way, so that's like manually constructing that shape. Let's delete this. The second way to do it would be to take this shape, since you already have it. I'm going to make a circle, hit the plus arrow. So I hit C to make the circle, then the up arrow to lock to that blue axis. I'm going to select my path, hit the follow me tool, select my shape, double click this, make it a group, delete this line. Now I should be able to use that endpoint here. Just put that right where that point is. I want to make sure that this is a group. Now what I'm going to do is use these solid tools. So if you right click, if you don't have this bar for whatever reason, you want to right click in an open space and make sure that solid tools is selected. We're going to be using the subtract tool. Before you select the actually select this button, if you look at the top left, it says subtract first solid from second and keep only the result in the model. So select first from second. So we want to select our little pill shape and then the box. So I'm going to hit subtract, select my pill shape, and then select the box. You can see, there you go. Then you just want to flip these, reverse faces, go in here, again, E for erase. Just going to come in here and hold control and get rid of these lines. And you can see I have that shape. So for this, it might be a little bit better to use, like if you're doing all four corners, it might be better to use that other option, that I showed you with the pell shape, so you can just do all four very quickly. If for whatever reason the solid tool subtract isn't working, it might be because, let me go back just a little bit so you guys can see what could happen. If for whatever reason there was a line or a part of the geometry wasn't created, it won't let you select it. You can see when I go over this, this is not a solid. So if you have any sort of stray lines or the geometry isn't closed, it will not register as a solid and you won't be able to perform that operation. So if you're getting that for whatever reason, that's why. So you just have to be very careful about what you're subtracting from to make sure that you have some refined geometries before you can do that. But hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.